Good morning, friends. Now we are going to see the Mealy and Mori machine. Basically, this is a self-study part which is there for unit number one, right? So I am going to have a lecture for that one because many students have not understood the NPTEL videos, right? So first, tell me about Mealy and Mori machine. So in the first lecture, I told you about the hierarchy of the finite automata. So I have shown here. So finite automata is at the root level. So finite automata is divided into the two types. One is a finite automata with output, and second one is a finite automata without output. Right. So we are aware about the DFA and NFA. Okay, we have constructed the DFA, constructed the NFA. So these are the parts of finite automata without output. Okay, so without output means what? There is no output generation is there in case of DFA and NFA. So that's why they are coming under finite automata without output. Now there is one more category with the finite automata is with the output, and there are two machines which are available with the output. Those are called as what? Mealy and Mori machine. So today we are going to concentrate on this Mealy and Mori machine. So now it's clear is that Mealy and Mori machine consists of outputs. Okay, now we'll see first the Mealy machine, then we'll come to the Mori machine also. So now what is a Mealy machine is that, so similar to our finite automata, as you know that the finite automata consist of 5 tuple. So here the Mealy machine is consist of 6 tuple, right? Now as I told you that Mealy and Mori machine both are output oriented, right? So output in a nature. So that's why here it's a finite automata where the output is associated with the transition. Okay, so this is very important. Output is associated with the transitions, right? So transitions, all of you know that I have shown you one diagram here. So this is a state A, this is a state B. Now this is a B transition is there, which is starting from A state and it is ending toward A state only, means it is originating from A and it is going toward A state only. If I see this A transition, this A transition is starting from A state and going toward B state, right? So these are what are transitions of what a finite automata. So what the Mealy machine is that, in case of a Mealy machine, the output is associated with the transition. So if you see here, that B oblique 0 means what? Here B is a transition which is having output what a 0. So this 0 is a oblique part that is indicating what the output here, right? So similar here, A oblique 1 means what? 1 output is there. Here A oblique 0, 0 output is there, and B comma 1, it's what? It's output, right? Now as I defined is what, Mealy machine is a 6 tuple, right? So what are those 6 tuples is that, the 6 tuples are mentioned here. So first one is a Q, so that is nothing but total number of states, which is very similar to what my finite automata, total number of states, right? Now second one is what, input alphabet. So this is indicating what are the inputs that are applied. Okay, so these are coming to a transition. So this B, this A, so this will become what, my input alphabet. Now the one more new tuple that you will see here, which is not there in a finite automata, that is called as what, output alphabet. So this is the output alphabet indicated in this convention, right? So what is the output alphabet? So output alphabet consists of what are the outputs that are generated. If I consider this example, then my output alphabet is what, 0 and 1, because 0 and 1 are these outputs are generating here. My input alphabet is what, A and B. Okay, now coming to what next is what, delta is a transition function. So what this transition function is indicating, the transition function is nothing is that, if you are in on some, say some state, and you have applied some input, then where actually you are going. So that's what a transition function. So if I consider this A transition, then for this A transition, the originating state is A. So from a A input, if I apply the A, from the A state, if I apply the A input, then it is going to what, B state. So this is what a transition function, right? Now coming to what next is what a Q0 starting state, which is very similar to what my finite automata, which state is a starting state. So here the A state is a starting state because it is not indicated here. The starting state is always indicated by arrow here, right? So the arrow is missing here. So let me add this arrow here. So just adding a arrow, this is nothing but what, it is indicating what, a starting state. Okay, so This is or now there is a one more sixth one that we call it as what a lambda here, right? So what actually this is indicating lambda is what here output function. So output function means what it is telling about how the output is generated. It is telling about the output function. So the transition function and output function what both are what the they are related to each other. Transition is telling about how the transition is happening from this state, how it is going, what input you have applied and which state it has goes. So that's what a transition function, and what output function is doing is what you are on the A state, if you apply the B input then what output it is generating. So this is called as what a output function here, right? So this is a simple Mealy machine. So what the Mealy machine, now we'll come to what now second the note takings about the Mealy machine here. So the first note taking is what Mealy machine will not respond to the input epsilon. Okay, so this is very important. Mealy machine is not going to respond toward the epsilon. Okay, so before that one I will come toward the previous slide, and I want to tell you that this Mealy and Moore machine are not going to have the final state because these are not acceptor. Okay, these are what output generators. Mealy and Moore machines are output generators, so that's why here there is no concept of final state is there. So here there is no state which will come for as a final state here. Okay, so now we'll come to here. So this is a Mealy machine is will not respond to the input symbol epsilon, right? So how this statement is a valid, we'll see that. Okay, so now we'll consider one example here. So this example you just consider, this is a string. Okay, so we'll consider the previous example. The previous example means what this this state diagram or this Mealy machine. Okay, so we'll consider this Mealy machine, and for this Mealy machine we will consider this string ABABA. Okay, so now if there is a string ABABA, then how it is how the Mealy machine is going to generate the output, we'll see that one, right? So what strings we are having ABABA, right? So now I have written here, so you have started with the A. Why actually you have started with the A? Because A is a starting state, so always you need to start with the starting state only in case of Mealy also, in case of Moore machine also, in case of finite automata, that's DF and NFA also, right? So you have started here. Now the first input that you have the A. Okay, so now you are in the A state, so you have applied the A input. So where it has goes to, it goes to what, the B, right? So it is indicated. So this is a A state, starting state. You have applied the A input, so after applying A input it goes to what, the B state, right? Now from the B state again you have applied what the again from the B state you have applied the A input, sorry, B input. From B you are applied B, so again it has goes to what, A. So from a B state if you have applied the B input, so it goes to what, A. So that's why it is mentioned from B you have applied a B input, so it goes to what, A. So like this the sequence of the operations you will see here, that is mentioned here. Okay, so you can calculate, you can just pause the video and you can calculate whether it's correct or not. Okay, now coming to what next is what, as I told you that Mealy machine is having a output related to what, this transition, right? So this B is a transition, so what we are going to do is what, so this A is a transition, so what A output it is having, so A with the one output, so that's why output also I have written at the below here one. B, this B with the one output, so we'll check. So this is the B which is coming to the A, so this is what, the one output, so that's why here it is written one. Now coming to what next, A, again A means what, again it is going here, so it is written as a one output. So like this the outputs are written for those transitions, and also outputs are mentioned here, right? So you have considered this A, B, A, B, so these outputs will also be written here, right? So this is what the output. So now what we'll see is that what is the length of the input. If you see here, the length of the input here is what, a 5. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5, so the length of output that is generating also what, a 5. Okay, so that's why in a Mealy machine the length of input is equal to what, the length of output. So this statement is a valid now, right? Now coming toward the second statement, that is a note taking, that is a Mealy machine is will not respond to the symbol epsilon. Okay, now symbol epsilon means what, as you know is that symbol epsilon means what, it is generating from starting state only. Now here there is no epsilon transition. If there is a input epsilon, consider that the epsilon input is there with the A only, but The output is not generating. Why the output is not generating? Because epsilon is not having any transition here, right? So epsilon is not having a transitions, right? So that's why here the Mealy machine is not going to respond toward the epsilon. So is it clear to you? So why actually it is not generating, why it is not taking the epsilon input is that because epsilon input is not going to be accepted in case of a Mealy machine because there is no epsilon transition is there. Okay, so this is clear. Now we'll go to the next one. So this is what a construction of a Mealy machine. So we'll see the two example for this construction of Mealy machine. So construct the Mealy machine that accept all strings of A's and B's in which each string end with AB. Okay, each string end with AB. So what I want is that I want each string should end with what? AB. Now listen here. Okay, so here it's a not a acceptor, so that's why there is no final state concept, right? So each string end with AB. So how should I construct the each string end with AB is what? So I've started with the A. So what is the minimum string that is going to be generated here? For that output is going to be generated, right? So first we need to see that what will be the input and what will be the output here, right? So now what I will say is that whenever there is a AB string is generated, then I will say that output will become 1. Okay, so what I will say, whenever I will found a AB, then I will have the output 1, otherwise I will have the output 0. So now I got to know that I am having output 0 and 1, right? So this is my assumption, right? So you can also assume that, you can say that I will say C if the AB is not met. Okay, and if I get a AB, then I will say the D, right? So you can do like this only. So what I assumed here is what, when I will get a AB, then it will become what, a 1, and when I will not get AB, then it will become what, a 0. So this is my assumption, right? So now what I did is what? So here this is a state A. So I have drawn for the first minimum minimum string. So the minimum string that is going to be here is what? AB, right? So this is a A and this is a B that is came here, right? So now after that, here A, the AB is not here, so that's why output I have written 0. But I have written here 1. Why? Because AB, I got AB here. Right, I have got what, AB here, A and B. So that's why I have written here what, 1 here. Okay, is this clear to all AB? Now other part is what, very similar to what my DFA, that satisfy the condition of DFA. So both Mealy and Moore machine are DFA nature, deterministic. These are deterministic, these are not non-deterministic. These are what, deterministic in nature. Means what, for every string there should be one number of transition for every input alphabet, right? So that's why B transition is done here, A transition is done here, and this C's B transition will go toward the A state, and this C's A transition will go to this state, right? Now you see here, if I take one string AB, AB, okay, so AB, AB should be accepted. So we'll say AB one string, AB one string. So this is going to be generate what, the output here, right? So this is the overall funda. Now we'll see the next example. So construct the Mealy machine that accept all strings of A's and B in which every string ends with either AA or BB. Means what? Whenever the string will end with AA and BB, there should be output generation. So what I have assumed is what? Whenever there is a AA generation is there, the output will become 1, and BB generation is there, output will become 1. Okay. So now I have started with the start state, this A. So now this is a A here. Okay. So A and A. So A and A, so many A's are going to be generated, so that's why output will become what here, 1 here. Now here B and B, it will automatically become what, 1 here. So it can happen that on a C state A and B transitions might come. So this A and B transitions will go to what here, B state, and again it will come to what here, C state also. So A's will come to here, because if you are getting a B here, then again you can get a A, and again if you are getting a A, then it should become what, a 1. So that's why A transition is forwarded here and B transition is forwarded to the C state. Okay, so this is overall about the construction of the Mealy machines, right? So this is the two example. So I'm going to upload a next video, so in that I'm going to explain you about the Moore machine. So this is about the only about the Mealy machine. So in the next video we'll see about the Moore machine. Okay, thank you.